is a dark day. Most Mondays are. I was sitting in my office doing some math homework when the girl appeared. He was a sophomore, maybe a junior. It's always hard to tell these things. Either way, she was upset. Kept talking about how her boyfriend mysteriously disappeared over the weekend. Said he was going on an expedition to the jungle in search of ancient relics. I suspect he was looking for his old Pokemon cards in his closet. She won't listen. They never listen. Kept going on and on about something in the tree. He showed me an old sketch he'd found in his desk and I felt my heart sink. Determined to know all there was to know about my foe, I revisited my old evidence locker to look for clues. Sightings of the octopus had been steadily increasing in numbers over the years, and the amount of photographic evidence was startling. Still, no substitute for the real thing, and I appeared to have a specimen. However, because there's little physiological difference between the arboreal and aquatic species of octopus, the only way to be sure was to have the creature's slime test its tree sap. To do that, I would have to call in a favor to an old friend.
Hey, Nancy? Yeah, this is Traci. You remember that case I did for you a while back? Yeah, I'm gonna need you to return the favor.
Dr. Nancy Hardy was an old acquaintance of mine from a case several years back. The scientist's daughter of two famous detectives, she'd always felt a sort of connection to my work and could usually be coaxed into analyzing evidence for me in exchange for help with her own work.
Holly came from Miami, FLA. Hitchhiked away across USA.
Good to see you again, Doctor.
Put your eyebrows on.
What have you got for me?
I have bad news. It's lupus.
Oh, wrong case. I'm sorry. Well, it's pretty strange. It's definitely in the octopus family. But I found some tree resin in the sample you gave me. That's impossible.
You know what I'm...
Unless...
You know what I'm thinking, Doctor. It's gotta be it. I've been known to be wrong. They could exist.
Wow. Not the O pair of olives.
It seems so.
Well, you have been wrong before.
So they say. They tell me that a lot.
Fair enough. Is that all you need?
Yes, thanks again, Doc.
Good to see you.
My meeting with Nancy confirmed my suspicions as to the identity of my adversary. The tree octopus had evaded me for years, but now I was back on the scent. I would have to venture into the jungle, but I wouldn't be alone. If I was seriously going to go after the octopus, then I was going to have backup. And that backup would have to come in the form of Michael Riffraff Bolton, cryptozoologist. One eye, long hair, and no sense of personal safety. Whenever I needed someone to lead me to a desperately hopeless situation, Riff Raff was my man. He was good at what he did. There was no telling what Bolton would do at any given time. He was as unpredictable as his nickname suggested, and it was usually best not to push him. So I could only hope he was preparing for the journey.
Yeah, I know the trio. Yeah, I spy them all back today. One took my out in Nam, harsh, but I always had the itching to hunt for these Northwest Pacific ones, big, and Moby Dick, the pie. Taking many lives. This time, I'll get them.
Yeah!
set off, we were joined by Bolton's assistant, Ensign Generic, who brought up the rear of the party. The ensign was a young marine biologist who specialized in octopus ecology, and had developed an obsession with the tree octopus that mirrored our own. We were walking through the jungle when it happened. The death of Ensign Generic was a dreadful shock to the system, eliminating any disrespect we may have harbored towards our tentacled foe as we moved on toward the heart of the forest, guided by Bolton's careful step. It was late in the day when we came to the clearing. I had been prepared for the worst in our confrontation with our opponent, but even Bolton, a seasoned explorer, hadn't expected what happened next.
Dear God!
Is that...
I think that's my client's boyfriend.
I guess he's single.
Well, I guess we're too late to save him.
That's for sure.
I do need the skull. I think that I found him. I want to save.
Are you for real?
Yeah.
Oh my God!
Oh no. Riff, I think I found the answer.
What is this?
He's dead, Jim.
Oh, well, let's go.
We gotta get out of here.
Dude, Tracy? Man, Dude?
In the end, Bolton and I got out alive. But the same couldn't be said for Ensign Generic or my client's unfortunate boyfriend. It was hard telling him the truth. Someone had to do it. I was being paid, so why not? Admittedly, we hadn't completed the feat, but we survived and got the job done. Some might call it unethical, given a poor widow something so morbid. It was business as usual, and that's what we did best.
I am a passenger. I ride through the city backsides. I see the stars come out of the sky. Yeah, the bright and hollow sky. You know it looks so good tonight.